Hello everyone, my name is Muhammad Afifuddin. In this video, we are going to learn that how to design one-way slab. So in these types of problems, they will give data like they will give length of slab or they will give dimension of the room. They can give external loading or directly bending moment and grade of concrete and steel. So here is the procedure. First step is trial depth. Okay. As we know that L by D ratio for simply supported member is 20. For cantilever it is 7. Okay. And for continuous it is 26. Okay. So in case of slab, we have to multiply it by modification factor. Okay. So here our formula becomes D is equal to span upon 20 into modification factor for simply supported slab. D is equal to span upon 7 into modification factor for cantilever slab. Okay. And generally we take modification factor is equal to 1.2 to the 1.5. Okay. So between these limit we can take the modification value, or simply you can calculate the trial depth for simply supported slab. D is equal to span upon 25, while for cantilever slab, D is equal to span upon 10. You can calculate it directly. Okay. So second step is to find out the effective span. And in case of slab, the effective span is equal to center to center spacing or clear span plus effective depth, whichever is less. Then third, we have to find out the loading. And in loading, firstly, we have to calculate the dead load, then live load and floor finish, and by adding these three values we can find out the total load, and we will convert total load in factored load, and then we will find out factored moment and shear force according to the type of slab. Okay. Next step is area of tension steel. Okay. And here is the very important formula. You can use this formula to calculate area of tension steel for any member of the RCC. Like you can calculate the area of steel for beam, for slab, for columns, etc., etc. Okay. So you have to remember this formula. AST is equal to 0.5 FCK upon FY in bracket 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 MU upon FCK BD square into B into D. And then we have to calculate the minimum area of steel. Okay. IS code recommends for mild steel bars, the minimum area of steel should be 0.15% of gross area. Okay, gross area means B into capital D, that is overall depth. Similarly, for HYSD bar, AST minimum is equal to 0.12% of gross area, that is 0.12% of B into capital D, where capital D is overall depth of the section. Okay, and then for bent up bars, we will bend half the bar, that is we are going to bend alternate bars, and from the center of support the bending length is L by 7, and similarly AST at the support is half that of at the mid span. Okay. Now our next step is to find out the distribution steel. The distribution steel or distribution reinforcement is provided in the longer span of one-way slab. And this is steel as per the minimum reinforcement criteria, which is given as above. Okay, you can see here. And what are the functions of distribution steel? The function of distribution steel is to distribute the concentrated load coming on the slab and to protect it against the shrinkage and temperature stresses. And it also keep the main steel bar in position. Okay, so these are the functions of distribution steel. The formula to calculate the distribution steel is same as far as AST minimum. So AST distribution for mild steel bar is equal to 0.15% of gross area, while for HYSD bar, AST distribution is equal to 0.12% of gross area. Okay. Now here the spacing criteria has changed for distribution steel, and it should be less than 5D or 450 mm, whichever is less. That means we are calculating spacing for distribution steel first, then we will calculate 5D and then 450 mm. Okay, so among these three values, we have to pick the least value. Okay, now next is check for shear. And the shear force in the slab is very small and there is no need to provide the shear reinforcement in the slab. So this step shall be eliminated. And if asked in the problem itself that you have to check for shear, then it is to be checked only and no shear reinforcement are provided as it is impracticable. Okay. Now next step is to check for deflection. And we know the procedure how to check for deflection. Firstly, we have to calculate the percentage of steel, then FS value, and from the FS value and percentage of steel, from figure number 4 of IS 456, we can find out the KT value, that is for the modification factor. And then we will find out the L by D maximum ratio, and then we will find out L by D provided, and we will compare. And if L by D maximum is greater than L by D provided, then our section will be safe. Okay. Next and last step is to check for development length. IS code recommends that the value of MU1 upon V plus L0 should not be less than the development length. And here we will take MU1 is half of the value of bending moment, that is MU2 upon 2. Okay. In next video, we are going to see problem based on these steps. In this video, we have seen the procedure of design of one-way slab. Thank you.